It's getting cold. The persimmons in the Palace Museum are almost ripe. But despite the growing chill, the craftsmen of the Forbidden City are still focused on their work. A floor tile in the square of the Palace of Heavenly Purity cracks. Few people pay attention to the floor tiles when they are walking around the Forbidden City, so repairing them is a bit of a thankless task. Even so, for 600 years, they've been diligently maintained.
比如说你搁泥掉起来砖把往里放，又一看，泥太少，还得滴了出来啊。所以说它搁这泥挺考验眼睛。哦，是是，是吧？这是不是觉得打下去这点够呛吗？嗯，是不是觉得有点够呛？When
there's something wrong with a brick, tile, stone, or a piece of wood in the Forbidden City, they're repaired as quickly as possible. Timely attention to such details ensures this palace remains solid and beautiful. Over the years, generations of apprentices have become skilled at carrying out these necessary chores. Thanks to their efforts, these time-honored palaces will continue to shine for another 600 years, and their skills will be passed down to new generations of craftsmen. The Palace of Celestial Favor is the most distinguished palace of all the six Eastern palaces. It was once home to Consort Dongguo, beloved concubine of Emperor Shunju. Now, it is the Bronze Gallery, housing bronze vessels dating from the period since the Shang and Zhou dynasties. But visitors to this place seldom notice the blank space in the ceiling paintings of the main hall. According to documents, the ceiling paintings in the main hall of the Palace of Celestial Favor were probably drawn in 1697, over 320 years ago. But over time, they became loose, and this painting in the corner broke into pieces. Now the paintings are waiting to be repaired and restored. The repair department is north of the ice house in the Palace Museum. The water room is so lively that even the wet cat likes it here. This department grew out of the construction team established by the Palace Museum in 1953. And in its heyday, it employed more than 400 master craftsmen.
对，那松手，这个一闷，慢慢它就过去了。
Zhang Fengbing specializes in colored painting, Now, his most important work is repairing the damaged paintings of the Palace of Celestial Favor. Challenging though it is, this represents a rare opportunity for the youngsters to practice their skills. The Forbidden City, which itself has stood the test of time, also has to devote time to cultivating the guardians capable of securing its future. Every step must be taken to ensure that there will always be people on hand, capable of keeping the Palace Museum in tip-top condition. With that in mind, the Palace Museum has come up with a training plan to attract more young people to come here to learn the skills. Zheng Fengbing and the other four specialize in color painting, while the other four specialize in carpentry and tiling.
Cutting
bricks is a good opportunity to practice their skills. As well as being an important skill, repairing tiles is also an important aspect of the maintenance work. All things in the world are subject to time and the laws of nature. And the time-honored Forbidden City is no exception. But thanks to the efforts of the craftsmen, it is preserved from the worst ravages of time and remains as fresh and beautiful as ever. The restoration of the colored painting of the Palace of Celestial Favor enters the critical stage. Zheng Fengbing invites a man who used to work in this office to help them. Yang Zihua works for calligraphy and painting restoration team. 5 years ago, this room was the calligraphy and paintings restoration team's office.
Oh, 这块是这儿的。你瞧瞧，你瞧瞧。
又可能是这儿的。
对，你先洗头，行，这太稀了，稀了吗？这厚点了。这细头烫过吗？
行，
我先回去。真棒，这家伙打得真好。吃到点了吗？吃到点了吗？
就等着这花我呢。
太棒了。对，还直点，轻轻压一下，轻轻压，一遍一遍压，别着急，别着急，一下，因为他现在浆糊滑的，你太使劲，他跑了。嗯，你还得小心点，纸别粘在上面。完了，你回去那边挣工分去。我先回去了。
受累，受累，没事。
Yang Zehua sets the youngsters' minds at ease. Zhang Fengbing and his colleagues will use the traditional flour paste to repair the painting. Repairing cultural relics requires both caution and patience. When this bit of ceiling painting returns to the Palace of Celestial Favor, 601 years will have passed since the construction of the Forbidden City. What the tiling trainees face is an ordinary palace wall. These high walls divide the Forbidden City into many separate palaces. Many people spent their lives behind these high walls. Nothing sums up the Forbidden City like red coloring of its walls. Even for modern people, it's an ideal background color for their photos. But though the walls seem to be identical in color, thanks to the textures of the pigments used, each wall is in fact uniquely tinted. In the Palace Museum, what the trainees deal with are real cultural relics. Today, the trainees are beautifying this old wall under the guidance of their teacher. Wu Shengmao started working in the Palace Museum in the 1970s. He knows every wall like the back of his hand. The gaps between the bricks need to be filled in before plastering the walls. A duck-billed trowel is needed to fill the plaster into the gaps, and then fragments of tiles and bricks are used to fill in the gaps. The plastering of the walls is divided into two parts, the base and the finish coat. The basic material is fiber-reinforced plaster. Hemp is chopped and then added to the slaked lime. This can prevent the finished coat from cracking. The red pigment is added to the plaster. This is the secret recipe that gives the walls of the Palace Museum their iconic color. In the Qing Dynasty, this courtyard next to the East Prosperity Gate was the place of the Imperial Honor Guard. It was responsible for the carriages and ceremonial weapons that were needed for trips of emperors and empresses. Now this place serves as a warehouse, storing brick and stone parts from different periods of the Forbidden City's history.
这个吧，有科缺有脏，这个也这么写可以吗？对，我，因为我们提的这三件文物只是故宫特别特别特别不起眼的一部分，它对于别的展览可能意义没那么大，因为别的展览可能要美观、要纹饰。我们是认为我们看的是工艺，我们要你能看到它对它做过什么，对它有什么手工艺的操作，所以虽然是残件，但是对我们意义非常大。
Wong Li-ing works in the repair department. Conservation and protection of ancient craftsmanship is her field, with brick and stonework being her special field of expertise. These carefully selected cultural relics bear evidence of the skills possessed by ancient craftsmen. Now they and the age-old craftsmanship embodied within them are in the hands of contemporary scholars and craftsmen. In the early Qing Dynasty, this courtyard was where dining took place in the Palace of Compassion and Tranquility. In 1691, it was transformed into an imperial workshop to meet the royal family's increasing demands for various objects. Perhaps the repair department was set up here because of the long-standing tradition of craftsmanship in this place.
我是早上起来冷吗？这大衣。The
repair department also strives to improve the environment and surroundings. As well as leveling the ground, they'll also do some archaeological work, which should reveal much about the history of this courtyard.
还有那个拆的那城砖呢，嘉靖的，给我看看。哦，这嘉靖
15年，临清厂窑户，陆奎造。先生，您看一眼。行啊，你带着我。
The plastering of this wall is finished under the guidance of Li Zonglin, a national level inheritor.
这小块还不都弄完了，这不就一会儿的事儿？您这动作快，手里头都麻利了。The
master craftsmen of the palace museum are also men of action. Soon, Li Zonglin starts doing the work himself.
真的，真别那么远啊！ 这勺，你勺，您放心吧，哎呦，别那么跟大姑娘似的，拿起就落，这有什么呀？Li
Zonglin is showing them how to plaster the wall.
这就行了，行。第一遍糙着点，第一遍让它总底平。About
10 minutes later, Li Zonglin finishes his work. Now the wall looks smooth and as good as new. Traditional craftsmanship is passed down from hand to hand, and every master craftsman has some unique expertise they gleaned from older generations that came before them. The repair department uses this wall west of the Hall of Mental Cultivation as an experimental area in order to record the master's expertise. The department hopes to combine the visual effects of the wall and the as-built records and then to set standards for the plastering work. In a few days, the repair department's trainees will go to another place to perform a special task.
我完事了。Today,
they are not trainees at all, but teachers.
各位同学、老师，大家上午好。我先做个简单的自我介绍啊。我来自故宫博物院修缮记忆部，然后我是07年入的职，我在我的工作岗位上已经工作12年了，主要呢从事的是官式古建营造技艺的研究，还有培养保护工作。In
recent years, the Palace Museum has been working closely with colleges, middle schools, and primary schools all around the country, providing opportunities for young people to study traditional architecture.
等一会儿，从这边飞，从这边飞，啊，给找平了。那地粉先得看的图。这开始从这儿，啊，手一定要扶着哈。
Though these teachers are just trainees in the Palace Museum, to these children, they are master craftsmen. This is how ancient techniques are passed down to future generations.
Liu
Renhao graduated from the School of Architecture, Tsinghua University, and works in the Palace Museum's Department of Ancient Architecture. She has a keen interest in the use of traditional materials in restoration.
我们修复这个东西是没有完的，你永远可以让它做得更好。我们现在就是希望的是说，想要做到给每一件文物都建立它自己的一个病例。
那如果比如说再过200年，故宫800年的时候又要修这些东西，那当时的人就知道说600年前这些人他做了什么，用了什么样的材料和工艺。
In 1770, the rebuilding of the garden of the Palace of Peace and Longevity started, and Emperor Qianlong took charge of the project, which is why this garden is also known as Qianlong Garden. The Studio of Ancient Glory is the main building in the first courtyard of the garden. The ceiling is not decorated with colored paintings. Instead, it is decorated with nanmu, which is rather rare in imperial gardens. While these nanmu appliques are not as glorious as the patterns covered with gold leaf, they are still elegant. In 2001, the Palace Museum initiated a Qianlong Garden Research and Restoration Initiative. In cooperation with both Chinese and foreign professional organizations, it harnessed the power of scientific and technological innovation to cultivate the next generation of cultural relic protection workers, restoring Qianlong Garden in the process. Liu Renhao has investigated most kinds of adhesive.
文物保护用的最多的是这个叫做 B72 的东西，它是一种丙烯酸基的树脂，它的一个好处就是它是真的可逆。那比如说，现在这个，现在就是用胶一个特别大的问题，就是它那个胶吧，它会自己把它的盖子跟瓶子
给粘上，
对，它非常的牢固，就是。然后那就是现在我就后悔了，我他俩粘上了，我就怎么办，怎么能把它弄出来呢？我们就用丙酮，我们天天都干这个，特别搞笑。就我们这儿的胶天天都会把自己给粘在一起，然后过一会儿它就开了。然后这个也可以验证一下 B72 是一个可逆的材料，啊，还是可以打开的。老师傅们啊，用的都是猪皮，传统的方法就是把手蘸进去，然后你要这样来试。就是你要试这个胶，就是等你的手开始感觉到就被粘在一起有粘度的时候，你就大概知道这个胶，比如说会给你多长时间来操作。啊，就是我们其实特别怕这种很快就能让东西粘上的胶，像502这种，就是你贴上去之后你就不能后悔了，这个事儿就挺吓人的。那你看我现在的手已经就是看就是你要使很大的劲儿才能把它拔起来了，那就说明在咱们聊天的这段时间里，其实对于我来说我都还可以后悔啊，我把这个东西取出来就行，但现在就是对不起，这个东西已经没有机会了。那比如说这个是一个文物，那现在假如说我们过了100年之后有人在观察这个文物，那他怎么能知道这个胶说是2020年粘的，不是乾隆的时候粘的？比如说你用了 B72，那大家当然知道这 B72不是乾隆时候的，那个时候没有丙烯酸树脂。就是因为就是文物它很大程度上的变化，就5年10年之内，就是你可能10年后才能看到它的变化。你平时都觉得
It's not just wood that adhesive glues join together, they also bond time.Liu Renhao started to participate in the restoration of Qianlong Garden when she was studying for a master's degree. After graduation, she entered the Department of Ancient Architecture of the Palace Museum. From listening to others' lectures to giving lectures to younger students, Liu Renhao has developed alongside the restoration of the Qianlong Garden.According to the plan,The restoration should be carried out from north to south. During the process, experts and craftsmen run into one challenge after another.
反正就是宗旨，就整体的尽量能尽最小干预，然后最大限度保留历史信息。
是
啊，对，然后能保留都保留下来。
A seminar on the protection of colored paintings initiated by the Department of Ancient Architecture is underway.
项目的内容主要是对三座建筑呢，还有这个匾额。包括什么内容，就是现场病害成因的分析啊，还有彩画的这个周边微环境调查，包括这个材料啊，就是颜料、胶料、麻纤维、地障啊，各种材料组成啊。
这个东西因为虽然都是可能每个房子每个建筑有区分，但是大体的一些基本规律应该能摸到了的，病害也好，材料也好。
Wang Shiwei used to be the chief engineer at the Department of Ancient Architecture of the Palace Museum. He's played a role throughout the whole process of restoring Qianlong Garden.
那你这麻没有拔字儿？
麻起加固作用啊，
起加固作用。
加固作用。
听你说要保100年，有可能吗？这一阶段可能作业时间稍微得紧张。
20 years have passed.And the restoration project is coming to an end. Wang Shiwei has retired. But he's often invited to take part in discussions. He and his colleagues have left their mark in every corner of this garden and devoted their lives to it. Now, the protection of the colored paintings of Qianlong Garden is an urgent task.Facing the experts of the Department of Ancient Architecture.
Lamman 先测一下，看一下它的各项异性。
In recent years, the Palace Museum has cooperated with domestic and foreign scientific research institutions extensively and applied the latest scientific and technological innovations to ancient cultural relics.
看看修过色系，很平的没有啊？对，从这缝子竖出来一个胶，这个整体已经贴到这上面了。整体可以。
After some discussion, the Department of Ancient Architecture decides to apply the new material invented by its cooperator to the Pavilion of Soaring Beauty. The scientific and technological workers from all around the country have left their traces in the Forbidden City. The colored paintings in the Pavilion of Soaring Beauty are a variant of Suzhou-style decorative painting. Mountains, water, figures, flowers, insects, and fishes are all common subjects. Cyan and green are the main colors. Now these colored paintings have flaked. They are waiting to be restored. The first step is to clean them and remove the dust and bird droppings from them. Then they use syringes to inject the glue into gaps in the paintings. The next step is to cover the paintings with paper and fix them with wooden boards. The glue will become dry a few days later. While the technicians are busy with their work, Yang Hong, an expert on colored painting, also comes to the site. She'll experience the whole process, gaining valuable experience of colored painting restoration along the way. Experts hope to extend the life of the cultural relics and at the same time to build a cultural relics protection plan that will provide reference for similar restoration projects in and out of the Palace Museum.
我觉得这个彩画清洗比那个修清洗什么那个家具有什么那个难感觉倒在外但是尘土特别多感觉就是拿这棉签就一点点这么滚对。Thanks
to the help from modern technologies, this 120-year-old colored painting takes on a whole new look. As for other representative colored paintings in Qianlong Garden, Yang Hong opts for the traditional way of preserving them before they crack, to copy them.
Oh.
Qiao Jianjun is a student of colored painting expert Wang Zhongjie. He's been invited to the Palace Museum to copy the paintings with Yang Hong. When copying the paintings, they need to make sure they use the same pigments and technologies that were used in the past.
上次传了13个，嗯，对，所以就有的外边单位的人可能就是能看出点来吗？Young
Hong comes to the Department of Conservation Science with the samples of the colored paintings.
都这么磨一遍。
对，它这个样品是夹在中间的，我只需要把这个横截面给磨出来。
Under the microscope, the pigment particles clearly show what colors were exactly used. The ultramarine color in the samples is from the commonly used cyan pigment. It is the background color of most Suzhou-style decorative paintings.
他可能先刷这个，上面再照。
哦、对对，你说对，我就是想看看它这个细节，看。
对，它这个连绒带。
所以这个取样位置的准确记录
非常重要。
对，
而且必须是咱这两部分人结合起来。
Based on the paint formula provided by Yang Hong.Qiao Jianjun starts to color the copies.
也是采花的博物馆。
其实真是的嘛，跟古人对话呢，现在就是，尤其是画那种那个难度大点的，那特别有兴趣的，哎呀，真是一种感觉，哎呦，就好像跟一个老师在教东西一样的那种感觉，因为你跟别的老师学不到了，没那种机会了。
Qiao Jianjun cherishes the opportunity of making copies of the colored paintings of the Palace Museum. The Palace Museum houses the masterpieces of those nameless craftsmen. These works inspire modern craftsmen to keep improving their skills.
前面这个第二个坐着这个，从东边数第二个。对，我爸那时就是在那个复员军人，以后就复员在故宫了，就一辈子在故宫，老故宫人。但是是那时就是因为得癌症，因为2005年去世了。他原来一直是开封部主任。每天下学的时候，然后从北池小学下学以后，就顺着那个河，然后那个走一圈，然后从神武门进来，然后我爸他们那部门就在这前面这一排13排，那个东神武门，东大房那一溜。
The hall for ancestral worship is the place where the emperors kept the memorial tablets of their ancestors. It was the royal family's ancestral hall. In the Qing dynasty, a grand ancestor worshiping ceremony was held here on the first day of the first lunar month every year. 600 years after the completion of the Forbidden City, this hall looks tranquil from the outside.But in the hall, many people are busy working. In ancient times, ancient people used fir wood and hemp ropes to build the scaffold while they built the high palaces. Today's modern scaffolding is much more convenient and solid. Once the scaffolding is installed,An overall physical examination of the hall will get underway. The main hall of the Hall for Ancestral Worship is decorated with imperial-styled colored painting. The whole ceiling is magnificent.
你们上次灯在哪儿呢？
就在这儿。
In the past, Yang Hong could only look up at the colored paintings on the ceiling like visitors do. But now, she can finally take a closer look at them.
Yeah, 这上的，谁给我照一下灯？对。
It will be another 100 years before the Hall for Ancestral Worship is due for another checkup.
故宫的建筑里头哪个是用金量最多的建筑？也许有人要回答说是太和殿，是不是你会想到这个？但其实不是，用金量最多的就是奉先殿，它前殿全部是那个混金的。上梁，在民间的时候吧，它会放铜钱儿。啊，但是呢，像皇帝的一些宫殿建筑，基本上都画上彩画。
Ridge purlin is the uppermost truss component of the roof structure. The colored paintings on the ridge purlin usually go unnoticed. Yet every corner of the exquisite imperial palace was carefully decorated by craftsmen.It's said that when an auspicious palace was completed, colorful clouds would appear in the sky. For that reason, the motifs on the ridge purlin are auspicious clouds, a symbol that this building is blessed by heaven and will stand here forever.
奉先殿，
奉先殿，
奉先殿后殿，明间吉林。
Yang Hong once again turns to Qiao Jianjun for help. They'll copy this unique colored painting.
我再照两下就下桥。
那这跟以前别的地儿啥不一样？从那顶着
面。以前我们顾不着这个，它那架子特别高。没架子，然后你登梯子你又不敢，太危险是吧？你上去还不具备这种条件，所以说现在你像这种镶有的图案，终于是弄成真的了，可以一下把它塌下来了，特别好，机会很难得。我还手上呢，我先压起来，老崔啊。归那个古建部以后，把这个照一下相片，特别漂亮。哎，它那种大气劲，无法比喻的，就是老手艺人那点精华体现出来。干这个活特别有意义，自己干的。
您快乐的像个孩子，现在就是。
对，我不是因为录像特别高兴，因为我画着这个才高兴。你要是看见一个很好的那个纪录片，你那种高兴劲儿，你是不是很崇拜？是不是很想体验一下？就是那种感觉。这像战场上下来的人啊。
先战场。
嗯，对，用化妆吗？
不是，这才拍的是自然的状态。
The process of renovating and improving the surroundings of the palaces exposes some surprising finds. The repair department accidentally stumbles upon the ruins of some ancient buildings. 600 winters after the completion of the Forbidden City, an archaeological excavation gets underway.
把这个砖缝给露出来。
这冬天。冬天经过一晚之后，这个土冻得跟特别的坚实。 那这个都已经结冰了已经。
After returning from the archaeological site in Fengyang, Wu Wei immediately gets down to work.
现在我们看的这个位置就是能够就是可能揭示出明初这个紫禁城营建时候的一个印记吧。对，好，就西边。还没到啊，
就11米，
11.1米。
The large bases made of bricks support the stone plinths. Their size and the intervals between them indicate what kind of building this was and its scale.
虽然困惑很多，就是不知道它是到底什么样的一个未知的宫殿，但是已经揭开一点它的面纱，就是哦，这个宫殿很大。而且跟明初有很密切的关系。这边可以看到故宫的600年，
对，
就是从地下就是到地面到周边就是600年。这个太不稳了，坚持住，师傅啊。
我觉得是你该坚持住。
你们不要说，不要说啥。师傅扶好了，我的命就靠你们了。跟你讲，
The archaeological work continues.In the near future, more information about this site is bound to emerge.
可能故宫里面就说没有一个建筑或者没有一个遗址说它就是一个单纯的时代。它全部是一个历史的一个集合。
In one sense,Buildings are all we see in the Palace Museum. But behind all these buildings is time itself. The 600 years of construction and maintenance that have shaped and reshaped the Palace Museum, bequeathing us and further generations the precious legacy of the efforts of generations of builders and restorers.